Okay, guys, so the plan today is to remake the synth patch in the song 1 2 3 Days Up by Kim Petras. It's featuring Sophie. I'm pretty sure she produced it. And Sophie is one of my favorite, absolute favorite producers right now. She has such a different sound. She is so good with synth sounds. I think she's a genius at sound design. So today, it just makes sense. We need to try to remake the synth patch that Sophie made for this Kim Petras song. I'm going to play it for you right now. One day's up, 2 days up. So just that section. I'm just gonna focus on remaking that section because it's just a vocal and it's just a synth patch. Things I notice initially are that one, it sounds to me like the synth patch is made mostly out of square waves. And second of all, there's so much pitch glide happening. It's absolutely insane. But it really makes the synth sound sound cool, I think. I'm gonna listen one more time and then I'm gonna come back with a remade version for you guys. One day's up, 2 days up, 3 days up. We don't stop, we don't stop, we don't stop. One day's up, 2 days up, 3 days up. We don't stop, we don't stop, we don't stop. Okay, so you can see we got pretty close. The original sounds a little bit bassier and everything's glued together a bit more, but that is to be expected. So this is the sound that I was just adding on with the vocal. Little bit of high end still happening from the original, but it's not a big deal. This is what I came up with. Pretty filtered out because we did have a lot of high end from the original. For starters, I thought that the synth patch was mostly maybe 2-3 layers. I couldn't have been more wrong. I tried this and I could not get anything that sounded similar. So I had to default to doing probably 7 or 8 layers that are all quite mono. All right, now I'm gonna go through a few of the synth patches just so you get an idea of how they were made. This first lead sound is arguably the most important besides the bass. And it's really just one square wave with 4 voices. Detune is down a little bit and the envelope here, very, very short decay and release time. And I drag this envelope onto the cutoff, which is creating that pluck sound using the filter. And then, very, very important, I clicked mono and legato down on the right corner here, underneath, just underneath the voicing label. And I also clicked always next to the portamento time, sorry, and turned up this portamento time knob. This portamento time, it's hard to say every time, this portamento time knob creates the pitch bending effect that you want in this kind of synth patch. And then finally, I also adjusted this curve by pushing it up so that it slides a little bit slower, just so that you really hear that pitch glide every time the note hits. Also part of this sound, to get the real long pitch glide, is you need to have some slip notes. This A sharp is going at the same time as the C, so that it really glides from the A sharp to the C. This one has the third of each chord and has an acid wave. I think at this point I was just trying to add a few layers, really just trying to give it some thickness and some beef to the sound. This is sort of the high bass sound. A sine wave that I'm pretty sure I just brought an octave up from the low sine wave that I started with. This bass patch had a different rhythm. little tip, it's often really good to start with the bass line if you're trying to transcribe something from ear. It can just give you a lot of hints into how the rhythm is, and also it's the bass line is usually the root note of every chord, so it can help with voicing the rest of the chord with the rest of the synth patches. I found the sound, the synth patch sound in the original, to be very clicky. It almost resembled the sound of a metronome hitting every time the synth hit. And this is probably some kind of noise oscillator sound that Sophie had going in her synth, whatever synth she was using, that was a very tacky sound, but it really resembled a metronome for me. So I actually sampled the Ableton metronome with my phone and brought it into Ableton, EQ'd out most of the frequencies, and just kept a bit of the attack from the metronome sound, just to add some rhythm. And this hits every time the notes hit in the lead melody. Now, before I forget, these are all under a group channel, and in the group channel in Ableton, I am crushing them with a lot of different effects and compression. That's it pretty much for today. I hope you guys gained something out of this. I think I really learned that, you know, sometimes you just need to add more layers, and crushing them all together with compression can just make a new sound like you've never heard before. Yeah, that's it for this video. I will be back with more videos, more tutorials. I will see you guys next time. Bye for now.